Hyperconverged infrastructure is increasingly common, and Windows Admin Center can help you easily deploy many kinds of clusters, including hyperconverged infrastructure. Hi there, I'm Jeff Woolsey, and this is one in a series of videos that shows you what's new in Windows Admin Center. Windows Admin Center allows you to streamline everyday tasks and connect to Azure for hybrid scenarios. In this video, Cosmos Darwin will show you how to use Windows Admin Center to deploy hyperconverged storage. This feature is currently under active development and available in preview, so you can try it early and share your feedback. Let's get started.
Hyperconverged infrastructure is rapidly becoming the normal way to deploy servers on premises. And that means it needs to be approachable for everyone, from Fortune 100s to small businesses. That's why Azure Stack HCI is available on over 150 solutions. Whoever your preferred vendor of servers is, we are working with them to build solutions for you. Because we know that infrastructure is never one size fits all. And to illustrate that point, I'd like to tell you about one of the newer solutions that's very cool. This is the Lenovo ThinkSystem SE350 Edge Server. Inside, it's all server-grade parts. It's got an Intel Xeon processor, DDR4 error-correcting memory. It's got dual 10 gig networking that's iWarp RDMA capable, and from 4 to 8 NVMe SSDs in each server. If you've been following Storage Spaces Direct over the years, then you'll recognize that this server is perfect for hyperconverged infrastructure. And it packs all of this into a form factor that is so light and small that you could conceivably put it in your carry-on, fly to Microsoft Ignite, and walk on stage with it in a shoulder bag, and the audience might not even notice. In fact, this is the SE350. This is the future of edge computing. Compact, connected, rugged, and running Azure Stack HCI. And to deploy my very own hyper-converged infrastructure, all I need is two of these. I don't even need a high-speed switch. I can connect them back-to-back using crossover cables. Let me show you now just how easy this can be to set up. We begin in Windows Admin Center version 19.10. You'll see at the top there's a new solution called Cluster Creation. We can actually use this to deploy all different kinds of clusters, including a classic failover cluster. But for this demonstration, we'll choose hyperconverged infrastructure. You'll notice that the workflow takes the form of sort of a multi-stage wizard, so it's going to guide me through every step of the process. This first screen gives me some prerequisites, like I have to install Windows Server, fair enough. And next, I'll put in the credentials that I'm going to use to manage these machines. There are my creds. Now I'm going to point Windows Admin Center at each of the servers that I want to use to create hyperconverged infrastructure. In this case, I've named them Edge HCI 1 and Edge HCI 2. Windows Admin Center goes out and finds them, and you can see they're both running Windows Server 2019, and they're both SE350 Edge servers. At this point, if there were any Windows features that I needed to install for hyperconverged infrastructure, I could do so with one click, but in my case, they're already installed, so the next step is networking. As I mentioned, each of these Edge servers has two 10 gigabit network adapters, and there's also a 1 gig that I'm going to use for management. This is important because it means Windows Admin Center will connect over that adapter, and I can safely reconfigure the other ones without risk of losing connectivity. On this screen, I can input all of the key properties of the network adapters that are between these two servers, like their IP address. I could provide a VLAN ID if I need to. But in this case, everything looks right. Next, it's time to create the Hyper-V virtual switch on each of these servers. This is actually a fairly sophisticated step behind the scenes, but you'll see it doesn't need to be complicated. You do have access to all the advanced options. They're there, so you could turn off vMMQ or change the load balancing algorithm if you felt so inclined. But you don't need to, because all the defaults are already set to what Microsoft recommends. So I'll click Next, and we'll create the virtual switch on each server. Next, it's time to form the cluster. Validating the cluster runs a comprehensive suite of checks to make sure that these servers are suitable for clustering. In this case, you'll see that they are. I set it up so that we get a warning, just so that I can show you. You can download a full report of everything that we checked. You can also just browse its contents directly here in the browser. So you'll see the warning I got is that there's an update that I could apply. But for this demo, that's fine. I can continue. I'll give the cluster a name, like Azure Stack HCI, and then I'm ready to create the cluster. This will go out. It'll enable the cluster service on each of the machines. It'll form them into one Windows Server cluster. And when that's done, all I have is the final stage to enable storage. As I mentioned, you'll see each of these two edge servers is packed with four NVMe SSDs. You can actually add four more as well. This is perfect for Storage Spaces Direct. At this stage, I could clean them if I needed to. This is helpful if you're deploying over and over again on the same hardware, but in my case, it's a new system, so I don't need to do that. And all that's left then is to enable Storage Spaces Direct. I'll click. And you'll see this takes a moment because it's doing actually quite a lot. Behind the scenes, it's taking those NVMe SSDs from each server, combining them into one software-defined pool of virtually shared storage. But once it's done, that's it. I've deployed my very own hyper-converged infrastructure using these two edge servers in just a couple of clicks and a couple of minutes. What do you think? I am really proud, on behalf of both Microsoft and Lenovo, to announce that this entire solution you just saw, all the innovative hardware, the software, the services, everything you need for an Azure Stack HCI, starts at just $20,000. We know that for branch office and edge, the per location price point is really critical, so we're really proud of that. You can find the SE350 and over 150 other solutions at microsoft.com/HCI. And you can preview the deployment workflow that I just showed. The documentation is at aka.ms/deployHCI.